My name is Kayla. I'm 21 and I'm from Albany, New York.
My name is Erin Constantino. I'm from Leominster, Massachusetts, and I'm 21 years old.
Just being around all my friends, making memories, enjoying senior year to the fullest.
So after a long day at work or even a day full of classes, knowing I can come home and see everyone and everyone's cooking in the kitchen or watching Netflix, it's just nice to have a place to come home to and see your friends.
Applying for grad school, it is hell.
So I was at work today and I was thinking about this question. And recently, for the past couple of weeks, I would have so much on my plate and I would get something done and then I'd feel so happy and all of a sudden a million other things would come on my plate. So I'm never done. When I do one thing, I feel like I get hit with another thing.
I'd have to say there was one night when all of our guy friends and girlfriends were all at one house and I was outside with two of the guys and we turned around and looked inside and we literally just saw a perfect friends moment. Like when they pan out at the end of the screen and you just see the window and the lights are on and like everyone's chatting and talking and like just dancing and being happy and just being able to like actually realize to like take that step back and just to see the bigger picture and be able to soak all those memories and happiness in was just a really special moment that I'll probably remember forever.
So one of my favorite memories, it was freshman year. It was like the last week into school. It was like the beach party and we went to all these darties, but it wasn't like that. But I remember it started off, we were all like on the 63's patio and we were doing homework of all things. And one of us said like, listen, there's this party at the beach, like it's our last weekend, let's just go. And it turned out to be like, one of the best weekends, one of the best nights. And I was talking to Kayla about it. And she said it was like a happy accident. So I feel like those are the best moments in college, happy accidents.
So before you go to school, everyone tells you that it flies by. And you just want to like take those times that you have and appreciate them. And my boyfriend Drew told me one time that the best thing that we can do in situations like this is to just take a step back and look at all around us and just be able to like soak that in and appreciate every second of it so it can last forever.
So shockingly, this one came from my brother, and he said, he meant it in a different way, but he said, when you walk into a room, if you act like you're supposed to be there, no one will question you. And I've kind of taken this in my own way, and whenever I have anxiety about going somewhere, I think about that advice, and it makes me feel better, so thank you, Michael.
'Cause them blood dance, deeper than love with my friends. People coming, some people going, some people ride to the end. When I am blind, in my mind, I swear they'd be my rescue, my lifeline. I don't know what I'd do if I'd survive my brothers and my sisters in my life. Yeah, I know some people, they would die for me. We run together, they're my family. When I get up, they gon' be high with me. I'll stay forever, my family. Stones. When I am blind, in my mind, I swear they'd be my rescue, my lifeline. I don't know what I'd do if I'd survive my brothers and my sisters in my life. Yeah, I know some people, they would die for me. We run together, they're my family. When I get up, they gon' be
That I'm most upset that I didn't realize that the last time I saw certain people would be the last time I would see those people, or like the last time like we all did something as a group was gonna be that last time we did something as a group. Like, that's, it's really hard to grasp that part of it.
How did the virus affect you? I think for me and my friends and all seniors, it was kind of something that happened so fast. You know, I got back from spring break, was trying to get, you know, acclimated back into school, and all of a sudden I find myself home in less than a week, and everything canceled. So it really I don't think it's really hit me yet. But losing touch or just losing time with friends was awful. And the thought of senior year being canceled is just awful. So yeah, it's affected me a lot. I know in the bigger aspect of things, we're lucky and my family is safe, and my friends are safe, but it's just, it's affected a lot.
Well, I know that I'm gonna go back to my house at school at some point and see all my friends again. So it makes me happy knowing that at some point we're all gonna get back together and see each other.
What's making me happy right now? So with all the time that I've had at home, I've been walking a lot in my neighborhood, listening to music and just kind of doing my own thing, which has been really great, actually, you know, getting outside. It's something that I would never done at school because, you know, we're so busy with school and work and everything else. So again, in this tough situation, I found that walking just really helps out and clears your mind.
It's almost mid-April and I'm not at school with my friends, but in the long term, like, life is life. And what's really making me mad is that it's not even, I don't know, it's just that I'm senior year.
What's making me mad right now? So being home has definitely been a challenge with my siblings and my parents. I do appreciate everything they've done, but in these close quarters, it gets to be a little much, but I'm also miss my friends a lot. This was supposed to be, you know, a really fun couple of months, so that also is upsetting and makes me mad.
My best memory, I guess right now I wouldn't have anything specific. It would more of just be like those days where we just had so much fun all together on accident, like it wasn't planned. Just kind of happened.
The best memory I've had was going to spring break with Laura. We went to Ireland and visited Dublin and Galway. It was just a great week with, you know, no plans or nothing stressing us out. We just kind of did whatever, which was great. So that is my best memory.
As a senior who just got the rest of their year ripped away from them, my best advice would be to anyone of any age, no matter what you're doing, to make sure that you're enjoying it to the fullest and not taking any second for granted.
The best advice I've gotten is pretty simple, but something that I want to focus on for the end of senior year, which was to stop worrying so much and you really enjoy where you are and what you're doing. Which I think I started, but again, that's to not worry so much. And having my roommates there, you know, kind of helped. They try to help me out, but yeah, stop worrying.